Today is International NASH Day, a day where doctors and researchers try to raise awareness and visibility about a prevalent and serious health condition that affects the liver. Now, it's only expected to worsen over the next 20 years. Dr. Laura Alba, St. Luke's Medical Director of Hepatology, explains.
Yeah, basically, there's a buildup of fat in the liver that is not associated with a significant consumption of alcohol, and that in some patients can lead to inflammation, and it's mostly associated with patients that are overweight, that tend to have diabetes, high blood pressure, and high cholesterol. In some patients, it's not only fat buildup, but it can lead to inflammation and eventually scarring or damaging the liver. That can progress, and depending on your genetics, how fast that could be, but it can lead to cirrhosis, and cirrhosis can lead to complications like liver failure and liver cancer. In the early stages, there's not a whole lot of symptoms. Some people might feel more fatigue, maybe some mild nonsense right upper side abdominal discomfort. But for the most part, when symptoms start, like yellowing of the eyes or fluid buildup in the abdomen or swelling of the legs or mental fogginess or vomiting blood, by then the disease is very advanced and already the patient has reached the stage that we call cirrhosis. So it's important to recognize that you have fat liver early on, so you have to talk to your primary care doctor when you have risk factors, so that we know that this could potentially be a complication, like I mentioned, of diabetes or when you're very overweight, and look for it, because if you wait for symptoms, it might be too late. It is important because, unfortunately, other than eating healthy and exercise regularly to achieve weight loss, in those patients that do tend to have more inflammation and liver damage, the patients that are at risk of developing cirrhosis, we do not have anything that is safe and effective approved by the Food Drug Administration or FDA. So we need treatments for those patients that are going to develop more advanced and severe liver disease. We don't have them approved yet.
You can learn more about the causes and symptoms of NASH along with treatment options at stlukeskc.org/NASH.